So let me get this straight. You want me to fight Drisik, or you're gonna kill Alora? Or at least this person who looks like Alora, who, as far as I know, could be an imposter. You're gonna have to show me proof that that's Alora.
Are you willing to take the chance? The platform starts going lower. You hear Srihan. Aelond, is that you? Wait, please, it's me. It's really me. They locked me up after I'd gotten I guess that they faked my death. I don't know what they've been doing, but I've been locked up. Help me. Please.
I move to the front of the box and I stand as though I'm, you know, trying to get as close to Aelond as observing, and I just try and make sure that you take notice of me.
Yeah, you're pretty high up, so it's kind of hard to see you, but yeah, you'd be visible.
I mean, I'm in a golden dress.
Yeah, you stand out quite a bit.
Yeah, would that perception roll seer, or is Aelond too busy thinking?
Oh, to see Lexa?
Yes.
Yeah, you're more focused on the Alora person that is standing over by the water.
And what do I know of what was that? What kind of snake was it that he mentioned?
Dragon snake.
Would I know anything about that from galactic lore or something like that? Bureaucracy?
It would be galactic lore, probably.
How wide is the water that G's floating over?
Hold on a second. I have Pachez doing Pachez-y things at the same time here.
Oh, you can take your time with me.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm just... Alright, you should be able to see where you are now. Oh. That's where you ended up.
Perfect.
Oh, wait, I needed to move some cards around. Hold on a second. You don't get to do anything yet. I need to do that. Before you actually try and do anything down there. Okay! The water, she's over, like... It's 5 squares from the edge, generally.
All right, so where exactly is she on the map?
Can you not see her?
See that? See what I'm doing? Line?
She's up there.
I see blackness.
Oh, right, because you can't see out of the box right now. Oops.
I can see.
I can only see out of the right and bottom sides of the box. But the
okay,
top
let me get rid of the box now, since you're in it. No, okay. I forgot about that. My bad.
That's right. I have the supervision thing.
So you can see through walls with supervision?
If I was aerial, yes. Hold on.
Okay, now you should be able to see things. Can you see it?
Yeah, except for...
the pillar's right in the way. That's hilarious.
That little pillar is direct. There's a little...
Right in the way. Right in the way. That's hilarious. No, you can't tell where she's coming from where you're standing.
You're a guard. You don't need to know. Just stand there.
Well, that sort of ruins my idea, so never mind.
Are you, like, looking for her? Because I'm sure I could nudge her if I knew that you were looking. I could point her out.
Yeah, well, we'll just assume that I eventually saw her, but I was hoping that she was over, like, the more rivery part of the water where it might theoretically be feasible for her to jump off of the platform and make it to dry land, but I was just gonna use the force telepathy and just tell her to jump off the platform.
She'd be like, "You're insane, what?"
This is your kind of speaking. You need to jump right now if you want to survive.
Yeah, so, Aelond, with your galactic lore, you've heard of things like, if the name sounds familiar and you think it's a mostly aquatic creature, but it can also crawl on land. But they're pretty big. They're like over 20 feet in length. Out of character, I'll just tell you, it's the thing that eats R2-D2 on Dagobah in Empire Strikes Back.
So not a good thing. Since it can swallow R2.
As in, Aelond is now calculating how much ammo he needs in order to kill this thing.
Yeah.
So did they, press some buttons that we saw them pressing to lower her down?
You didn't say you were paying attention to that, so no.
I'm a bodyguard. I'm being constantly...
You were trying to figure out where she was coming from. You weren't looking at the controls.
Well, obviously, I saw them moving the controls before she even appeared, so I wouldn't have been distracted by her appearance.
I feel
well,
like
before they pressed the button.
We are trying to, like, figure out how this works. Can we at least roll perception?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, thank you. See, that's how you rules lawyer.
Oh no, what happened? That's terrible. I got a 4, you got a 12. Mine is only one worse.
My perception died.
Oh goodness. Okay, anyway, you saw him entering in commands on the control panel. It didn't look like there was like a switch that was like a lever being pulled to lower the thing. It was more like commands entered in.
Perception doofuses in here.
Yep.
Maybe Raydik saw something.
I don't know. You haven't asked him. Okay, so what's Aelond gonna do? We're gonna start rolling initiatives here. So, unless you want to have like some grandiose speechifying before we start doing combat.
Can you see me?
Aelond,
can you see me at all?
He is distracted. He wasn't looking in your direction. He's looking over towards...
Can I, like, gently tap the glass, trying to get attention? Just kind of, like, make it look like I'm absenting it?
I mean, if you want to get his attention, you should just tell Shyalu that you want to get his attention. Like, just force telepathy.
But you're, like, 10 feet behind me. I can't whisper to you. Okay, there you go. But I will. I'll elbow nudge you, and I'll nudge you with my elbow, and then I'll just down at it.
Oh, that was almost failing, but it wasn't.
But not failing.
It's really close, guys.
Classic nonverbal communication.
Shyalu, I don't know what Shyalu is supposed to exactly be communicating.
Like, look up?
We just think, look up, sure.
Look at us! Look! Hello! We're here! It's good!
I'm just imagining you say, hey.
We're gonna salvage the situation.
Your Scooby-Doo companions are here!
I mean, there's a... I see a solution. I don't think Shiloh's gonna like the solution.
Yeah. Let him go or it's over!
The fun solution.
My Shyalu's thought process right now is that, like, Aelond, in order to save her, is gonna, like, kill the other person, but then that's bad, so, because then someone's gonna die. So Shyalu's like, how am I gonna convince him that it shouldn't be a duel to the death? That's what Shyalu's trying to think right now. What's a more entertaining option for the crowd than a duel to the death by these two people? Pitting all three of them against the dragon snake, clearly.
Laura's gonna die for sure then. I don't remember. I mean, Ayla's told a little bit, but I don't remember battle-hardened warrior being anything he used to describe her.
So I'm just imagining this here. What's going through Shyalu's head? I will make the dragon snake jump out of the water and attack both of them. Is that something close?
Well, he was gonna try to ask the guy to do that.
Let's just see if we can get his attention first. If we get Aelond's attention.
They need an intelligence high enough to understand telepathy.
Yeah, that's not. It does not have a high enough intelligence to understand telepathy.
So y'all, has Shyalu told Aelond to look up?
I don't know what he was telling him.
Yeah.
He got off on a tangent of the dilemmas that the situation has put forth.
So you heard the words look up, but it sounded very confused.
Okay. Aelond will look up, I guess, towards the wherever he could find, wherever he could see. Probably up towards where y'all are, probably looking across. And as he looks up, y'all see tears streaming down his face.
I just give him the slowest of nods. Again, trying to make it not look like anything.
And Drizzt notices you looking up and looks up too. She kind of walks over to you. Aelond, you need to stall for time if those are friends of yours. I would say just kill me now, but there's no way. I don't think he's going to let you live. So if we can fight, make it look like we're fighting, he might give them enough time to do whatever it is they came here to do. But you have to fight me now.
All right. I'll do what I can. And Aelond will, at that moment, go into a fake elbow.
Fake elbow, all right. Roll deception.
I'm rolling knack.
I saw it roll into that one.
I was, man, got some really badly timed ones here.
We're gonna use all our force points today.
Destiny points too.
Okay, I'm gonna pull up initiative here. Nope, that's not initiative. That is false. Oh, I gotta get rid of everybody. Okay, roll initiative, everybody. Yay!
Almost everybody.
That's true. Yeah, you're still in a coma.
Sorry, Eagle. I got pretty good at
it. I thought you were gonna get the cure thing going before this happened.
Shyalu can cure you with force healing.
Yeah, thanks. That helps a lot right now.
Aelond should have, like, given her special lightsaber crystal. That could have healed her.
Does Aelond know that?
No.
She's in a bhakti tank, so, like, giving her an item means going through the glass and
just drop it into the tank.
Can't do that yet.
Like,
oh, yes. Here, Kalani, catch this.
Something rolled a 25. I hope it's the fuzzy one.
It was Raydik.
Oh, okay, that's fine.
Lots of things. La-di-da. Why did not that add to the turn order? That's annoying.
Do you not have an initiative rolling macro?
It did! It just didn't work. I clicked like the roll initiative and it did. I thought I had them selected, but apparently it did not.
Oh, that's cool. I have my own separate initiative thing.
I was going to do the shift click to open. It deselects the character.
Now that playing 07MA by Kaivar. What?
I uploaded things to Fanburst.
Is this from the new Star Wars?
Yeah, this is from Solo.
Yeah.
What? That didn't get added to the turn order? Oh my goodness. I'm annoyed now.
You just manually enter it.
Well, yeah, I know. But it would be nicer if it would. Alright.
I mean, I don't think being nice enters into.
Are you rolling from what, the character sheets, or do you have a macro for it?
I was rolling from the character sheets.
Are you making sure to click the
top? Oh, I rolled it from the trained thing down on the bottom instead of rolling from the up top thing like I should have, which is why it doesn't have the decimals in it for any of them. Whatever.
There, just put that as a macro, and then you can just click on a token and click that as a macro.
Yeah, I should do that. Anyway. Okay, turn one. Two with their claws.
Can't touch us.
But I figured. You hear over. That's more like it. Shyalu, what are you doing?
I am going to use Master Negotiator on Jerec.
Now's the time.
If I could find the button for it, or. A 2, are you kidding me?
Force point?
Yeah, I guess I'll use a force point.
If you try and convince him that you're not speaking at a turn as some rich person's bodyguard. So that's an 8.
That'd be a total of 34. Yep. So what are you saying to him?
Sporting. Maybe you should throw all three of them in the mix and let that monster out. That would be much more exciting.
A
I don't know. I don't know what we're trying to accomplish here. I can't just be like, you will surrender to us because we are secretly good guys. Like, I can't just do
that.
I was
going to suggest we different monsters. You do you. You do you.
Yeah, okay.
This is gonna... Okay. If Allura dies, I just want to let everyone know it's not me. I didn't do this one. This deception's all on that guy.
Yeah, Raydik just, like, his hands start glowing, and you see him just smack Jerec in the back of the head.
Oh, jeez!
Well, okay, if we were gonna do that, I would have done something different with my negotiation.
Don't kill him! I want to kill him!
But, wow, actually, no, never mind. I gave him such good defenses. Wow. So he tries, but Jerec hears the vibrations and dodges out of the way as whirs past his face.
Holy cow, Eddie! We weren't
with a 35.
So much for subtlety. Goodness.
Guys, your turn. Oh, I forgot to roll for the guards.
Yes.
Roll for the guards. Yes. I forgot to roll for the guards. I need to roll for the guards.
I don't even get to go until after the cap hounds go. This is how bad things have gone.
I didn't realize the fight was going to break out in this room.
I didn't either.
That's why I was trying to do whatever shenanigans I did. I don't know what I was trying to accomplish, but not a fight.
You and I think we're in accord. Apparently, we forgot to mention this to Raydik.
Mm-hmm. Raydik is channeling his inner Joseph.
Just you.
Inner Joseph or inner Moses? Because it was Moses who went me smash.
That's yeah. True.
Either one, really.
Anywho. Kaz, it is your turn. So you face down through the floor and you drop to the ground. Dangerously close to the edge of the water.
Of course you
But do. You're not in the water.
Which is the good news.
Yes, that is the good news. You're not in the water.
And now I will move as fast as I can towards the panel with the cabling. I can't really move myself.
Can you not?
Well, I mean, I can, but I moved the entire page. I still have that issue.
I don't get how that works.
Neither do I. It's never done this before, but now I move the entire page when I do that, so...
Well, because you zoom... it doesn't happen if you're zoomed farther in, because you're pretty close to where you want to go.
Yep, still does it.
Hmm.
I mean,
can you just hide your token with the arrow keys?
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Okay, so let me see. Can you mark where I remember the panel to be?
It's down there.
Okay, that's good. So let me see. I have 6 movement normally. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's good. They won't get here before me. Unless something surprising happens. Hold out for another round! And then hold out for even more creatures!
Aelond, I salute you. Good luck. Shyalu, how are we gonna run? I think in this circumstance, we're the ones in more danger.
I mentioned, don't try
the
exit.
Level of cap hounds, and there's only like 4 cap hounds in here.
I don't have my weapons. Me.
Well, I have them. It's simple.
You have to. You didn't give them to me.
Well, I didn't realize we were breaking cover already.
I realize that, but still.
I mean, you're standing next to him, and if he has it on his back, you might be able to grab something.
Hold still.
So the calf hounds start growling and circling around Raydik.
Oh, good. Yeah, I haven't done anything yet. I'm cool.
Lexa, your turn.
Okay, maybe I'm not so cool anymore. Okay, what am I gonna do? I mean, we brought it for this occasion, so I guess I pull out the detonator. And I say, whoa, now let's slow down here. Anything rash? And I just hold out there and say, before we do anything that regret, let's take a few steps back.
Question, how obvious is a radiation grenade?
Yeah, I'm not sure it's completely obvious that it's a radiation grenade.
It's a grenade.
True.
And I've got my finger on the button. Also, if he's an arms dealer, wouldn't he know?
Yeah, he might know. You don't know if he knows yet, because he hasn't gone yet.
True. But, I guess I'll hold this, and then for minor action, I'm going to position myself so that I can quickly grab a sword off of Shia's back if need be.
Okay.
Like, getting it off the weapon rack.
Do you also want to, like, move closer to him? So that, like, if...
I'll move, like, over
here. The image that, like, if you get attacked, then you'll drop the grenade and it'll be going off on him.
Yeah, I'll move over there so that I'm in between you and him. Oh, by the way, just in case you decide to ask me, this isn't deception. I know this grenade won't hurt any of my friends, so I'm not kidding when I say I'll use.
Yeah, I think it'd more be like an intimidate check or something. Alrighty, so going back to my Cosmap land. I'll move everybody.
Alrighty. Oh, it's the guard's turn.
Yeah, because it's the guard's turn. Can people see or do I need to add a flare? Do I need
to play? Darkness.
Okay, I'll add a flare vision. Sorry, hang on.
Darkness.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
You know, it's funny thinking about it. I can see everything. Nothing is dark for me at all. I have no vision limits.
It's lit down here because you haven't.
Okay, that's good. Eventually.
It's lit for now.
Oh yeah, I have the infrared mask on, so that's
yeah, and also yeah, for you it's not really gonna be a problem.
Do your job.
I'll at least see the things that try to kill me.
Can you all see now?
Yeah.
I can see.
Great. Down in Yay Corner.
Because you have one job. Do it already.
Ooh, I see Narglatches.
Yes,
hey,
yes.
What
you
is? Do I even want to know?
That's what those blue things are with the fantails.
Oh yeah, there are two.
How
red
bad
horse.
Are they?
Yeah, they're like, how could I have a gladiator arena and not have rancors? Come on.
I mean, they're not like the super big, you know, crazy ones, but yeah, cool.
And creepy vulture version viractals. What are those things?
They're from the Clone Wars. They're called Mastiff Falone.
And some calf hounds.
Alright, that is the guy that's above you. Because... Oh, that's a good roll.
Wait, he can see me?
I mean, you phased through the floor, the ground, and dropped out of the ground. I never said you cloaked, so...
I've been cloaked. I mean, I was cloaked the entire time, but okay. I don't really care about that much. Let me see, does that heal?
I don't think that works.
Yes, it does heal a little bit.
And then, then you landed.
That is way too many of the hisses.
Let me see, where's the heat energy? There we go. Yeah, and I'm going to spend force point to immediately do a force power at him.
So the cages of all of the creatures are made of nothing more except force fields.
That is correct.
So when the force fields go down, they just can all run up the ramp and all escape onto the arena floor.
Yep. Yeah.
That is a true statement.
Wow. Okay. I see what Kaz was talking about before when he was like, why are all these things force fielded? I did not realize.
You see why I didn't want to be down here when I have to do this. This is going to be unpleasant.
Learn to fly.
Trying to get energy and slam him into the ground.
Well, you should have dropped him in the water.
I'm not sure I could have moved him that far.
Yeah, you'd have to use things, because can you move people 8 squares?
Of all the things you can do, you can't move
6 squares, into yeah. Water. Yeah, you can't move him far enough.
I don't believe you, that sounds like lies.
I mean, you could throw him near the water.
Yeah, even with double, I'd probably have to use drain
all the energy from a starship. He can't move a dude 10 feet that way?
Listen, we all know how horrible the rules for this system are.
Also, telekinetic mastery of the force is very different than energy manipulation. The horn family, they couldn't even use the telekinetic version of the force.
Yep, he just flies up into the air and then slams down into the ground.
Okay. All right, and you see the other ones are running closer to you.
Is he still alive?
Miraculously, yes, he is still alive.
I'm disappointed. At least he heard some bones
crunch. Yeah. All right, Aelond, it's your turn. I'll switch it back to you.
Since I don't know what's going on upstairs, at least I don't believe I do.
Not unless you're looking up and seeing me hold a grenade.
No, that your body would be between
Lexa
me and
clone herself. There's two Lexas.
There's two Lexas. What?
Two? What?
Yeah, Lexa and Raydik are still in the crowd.
Oh, oops! I forgot to get rid of. Please hold.
Actually, Ariel with her loop. I've been Ariel.
Problem solved.
I mean, you guys didn't realize it.
Some I'm sorry, good, Ariel, but could you take this visage off of me? I'm not comfortable looking like this anymore.
Nope, you stay in the creepy robot. Sorry.
Oh yeah, thinking about it, is your communicator on, Lexa? Because I imagine the moment I turned on the scrambler, you just got a whole bunch of loud noise in your head.
Yeah, I probably turned it off as soon as I heard the noise. Because I usually do keep it open.
Alright, Aelond, your turn.
That must have been
I'm going to keep fake fighting.
Oh, I missed.
Something like that, yeah.
It'd make it more fun if he rolls enough to hit the person he doesn't want to hit, he doesn't hit them. But if he fails to hit them, he hits them.
That actually sounds like a great thing. I am on board with that, Zach. That sounds great. Yeah.
It's reverse combat!
Because you're aiming next to them, so if you mess up, you'll hit them. I can get on board with that.
He's trying to make it believable misses.
Yeah.
Well,
which makes it risky.
You can either, if you miss, it can either be you hit them, or it doesn't look believable. And you have to roll a deception.
Or you hit yourself.
No, you don't hit yourself.
When he hit himself, that makes no sense.
Yeah,
that
doesn't make any sense. Roll
he's trying to fake like he got a nat 1.
Oh, I'm so beat.
He lines up for a giant punch and makes it look super dramatic and then punches himself in the face, and then the whole crowd goes, oh, he got a nat one! How unlucky.
Or, he really sucks at fighting. Why are we watching him?
I'm going to straight up say if you actually ever hit Drisic, it will be a miracle. But continue.
Thanks. It will actually be a miracle because I can't melee for squat. Let's put it that way.
Oh, I'm not sure you could hit her with your blaster either.
Yeah, I could, but...
Are we saying...
Well, if you like net...
Wait, you mean so he's going to be accidentally hitting her all the time?
Fail to hit her? Or that her defense is so high that he couldn't legitimately...
Oh, let's find out. Roll!
What would it be for an unarmed attack?
Are you trained at... Well, I guess it would be, I think it's 1... It's 1d4, using your strength modifier and base attack bonus.
Well, that's damage.
Not the damage, the actual...
Well, yeah, it's 1d20, but yeah, the damage would be 1d4.
The attack plus. Is your base attack plus your strength modifier. Okay.
What's the negative applied for being untrained?
I don't think you need to be trained in unarmed.
No, if you're untrained, you just... Then your damage is 1d4 plus your base attack and strength. So, I know this because I have it queued.
Okay, so it's a 1d20 plus what?
Base attack.
Plus base attack plus your strength.
Yeah, I only have 2 attack options. I have my short staff and I have unarmed.
And all my weapons.
That's true.
Shyla starts wielding swords!
Dual wielding!
You bow to me!
Technically, his class allows him to lightsaber. He has one, so...
That's true. I guess, yeah, the only thing I'm trained for is... Although, is a heavy blaster a pistol? I guess I'm trained in pistols and lightsabers.
Yeah, heavy blaster's a pistol. You're trained in that. Yeah, so as you swing with your fist... You kind of tell that you were trying to miss, but Drisic is purposely putting her face right where your fist is going to be. Roll damage.
And that was...
1d4 plus
half character level.
Yeah,
plus strength plus modifier.
Yep, yeah, and then it's strength.
Okay, 1d4 plus character level, or base attack bonus, or character level?
Half your character level.
Okay, so 9.
And then your strength. Though that's not bad.
Most of the damage came from half my character level.
Yeah, that's There she goes, reeling back. Alright. Jerec hits a button on his data pad.
Great. I hate it when they hit the buttons.
Yep. Shouldn't do anything.
We don't know what it does. It doesn't necessarily mean he's calling for help.
It scrambles wireless communications, so signals. Wireless.
I mean, if you say to someone to stand down, otherwise I'm going to blow up this detonator, then they just completely ignore you and start pressing mysteriously sketchy buttons on their data pad. I feel like you should probably just use the detonator, otherwise they totally call triple up.
Not her turn yet.
I agree. I feel like now I have no choice.
Can you prepare an action to detonate it if anything sketchy happens?
So are you detonating it now?
Yeah, the door's being totally sketchy.
Okay.
I warned him.
I'm all so right, excited.
Roll it.
And I just can't hide it.
What am I rolling?
Where was the rules?
I'm not having to roll the hit, right? I'm
make
holding
a
it.
Handle attack roll.
Yeah, do I have to roll the
two
hit?
Two squares. If you throw it, yes.
If you're throwing it, yes. If you're holding it and detonating it, no.
It's not going to hit everyone here, though,
gonna,
if you don't throw it forward.
I'm just going to press the button, and then I'm going to roll across the floor. I'm not going to throw it. I don't need to.
Well, you'd still have to roll for a hit to see if he takes full damage or half damage.
I'm, like, literally 5 feet in front of me. He's right. I can breathe on him.
And maybe you will roll terribly and throw it into the arena and hit Aelond in the face.
In fact, actually, I don't even need to throw it. I could just walk over and put it in his coat pocket, which is what I'm going to do. Okay.
Well, in order to actually put it in his pocket, you're going to have to roll an attack roll.
Fine.
This is true.
Can't just be pickpocketing my NPCs.
You smash it in his face.
Actually, if we're talking, if you want me to make a sleight of hand check, that's a deception.
But he also saw you holding it and you kind of threatened it, so he is very aware of the grenade at this point.
It is combat.
Yeah, so I'm going to get a sleight of...
Grapple? I'm going to do grapple.
Do you want to just hug him and detonate it?
No, I just want to grab him, put it in his pocket... Let things happen.
Let's just say grapple. Grapple makes sense.
Yeah.
Whether it's hug him or grapple it.
I'm not gonna hug him. That's stupid.
It's not like the grenade's gonna hurt you.
But it's too many. Too close. Okay. The I'll just throw a destiny point on that. Or non destiny. Not a destiny point. A force point.
Destiny point.
I gotta save those for other things. Okay, 35. That's kind
of... Oh! No, sorry. That doesn't work.
Well, the grenade's still active.
Yeah, but he manages to hit it out of your hand, and it goes flying. With a nat 20. Hey, it's a nat 20! What's the burst radius?
Two squares.
I think it should fill the room. It is a radiation grenade, after
all. I mean, the rules say it's two squares.
So I was preparing up my move actions here. If people threw grenades, I could redirect them. So if it goes flying in the air, can I redirect it?
Oh my... That was a very... Did you actually do that this turn? Didn't you use your control, like...
I used the Master Negotiator. That's only a standard action.
And what are you using to do this?
Move light object.
The right direction, because apparently this is stupidly hard. He's right in front of me. I could spit on him and would not miss.
I guess, yes, you can.
That was such a reluctant yes.
This is ridiculous.
I mean, in some of the books, like the Clone Wars books, it says a use of move light object is to be able to move grenades that are being thrown, so...
I mean, and we kind of discussed this, so plans kind of already...
Yeah, I know, it's just like a reaction on top of a reaction on top of a nat 20. So, I'm gonna say you have to roll really well in order to successfully do this.
But the nat 20 is versus him grappling... her.
Yeah, but that 20 is what caused
throwing the grenade so hard that I can't grab it with the floor.
You're moving too fast for you to see. You didn't notice it. We're all waiting.
What do I need?
Just roll, please.
Roll, use the force, and roll it. Yes! That's a 17! You should throw a force point on that just in case Kylar decides to do something funky.
I'll use a force point.
He's already hesitant with this. I can see him looking at for wiggle room.
There we go. Yeah. I better be able to grab a grenade with a 50.
Yes you do. So where are you putting it?
Well,
in
I guess
face.
I don't want him below us up, so I guess we'll put it like... So the two square burst means, should I just choose four squares that are going to get hit by it, or what?
If you need to hit me, that's fine. Better me than Raydik. You might get mad.
Oh, well, oops.
Too late.
Great.
We need to hit more of the Cathhounds.
I appreciate it.
It's not my fault. The grenade was just flying through the air. I did the best I could.
Roll the damage for the grenade, Lex.
I will get one of my roll.
It's 3d8.
Wait, do I add anything to that?
No.
Other than you know. Okay. I apologize for that lame roll.
Wow.
I'm really sorry.
Are you far away from your microphone, Bezak? Yeah, you sound a little strange.
Really quiet,
Bezak. Yep. I had it up for a second.
Right, okay, so that was all after he just tried to type something on his data pad, so he still has a standard action left. What?
Did Raydik get hurt by that?
Yeah. I mean, it's an explosion.
Use Cycle of Harmony and give Alexa bonus hit points.
Okay, you can do that.
How many hit points from his pain?
I think everyone probably took the base damage from that.
Anywho. Anyway. So, see that his data pad is non-responsive. He reaches for the control panel that's actually, like, in the building and presses the button.
The control panel that's...
He was still standing next to it.
On all sides.
He was still standing next to it. He didn't back up away from it.
Where is it?
It's just there. It's not
my people.
Well, which one is the enemy dude?
It's there. He was standing there the whole time. He hasn't moved, and he was typing at the data controls before.
So I'm, like, it's in between him and I?
Yeah.
Oh, so I reached over the control panel, tried to bring him over and put the grenade in, but then it flew out of his hands, and then Shyalu brought it back and put it in his face. Awesome. Fingers crossed Raydik won't hold this against us.
He only took 6 damage. He was the one that
started fine.
The fight.
He's fine.
Yeah.
Weird things are coming.
So you hear like a whirring sound behind you. And he's just like, was that a radiation grenade? Really?
I mean, I warned you. This is on you, dude.
Okay, let's see. Gotta add them to the turn order.
I have a bad feeling they're turtles.
Oh no. Oh great. Okay.
It's almost like they have a ridiculously high initiative.
Well, this is the danger.
Don't worry, Alora can survive being shot by 4 turrets.
She's far enough away that they... No, wait. This is Star Wars. There is no such thing as blaster penalty over here because the ranges are ridiculous.
I mean, so line of sight, it means that a lot of them can't see things, but yeah.
Guys, how is the power going?
How's the draining the power? It's not going well right now.
Yeah, we're on timetable here. Is that coming soon? Next turn. Let's go.
Yeah, those are all at you, Aelond.
Well, at least they're not hitting here!
Only the 42 hits.
Yep. So that'll do not 72, that's 36? Yeah, 36 damage. And it'll move you an extra thing down that condition track. So you and Trisic are fake fighting. All of a sudden, blaster turrets fold out of the pillars and just start opening fire at you. And, alright, let's see here. So we've got, okay, 2 more here.
Kyrath, I forgot. Are we trying to save get him killed. I, you know, at this point, I'm not certain what the plans were. But that was that part ever put in stone?
About saving what, Jerec?
No, Aelond. I'm not certain if that was ever set.
Because that was the plan. So you're saying the plan can still be a success because you didn't say it was part of the plan?
I'm wondering at this point, since he's got literally every turret shooting at him, it's like, is that part of the plan? Or are we just like, yeah?
Yep, that's part of the plan. The plan of getting them out of jail requires them to be alive.
Yes. Okay. Sure does. Yeah. I don't think so.
Glad we can clear that up. And so this is...
Yeah. And on a scale from 1 to 98, I'm at about a 62 already, so think about that.
Alright, so Drizzly's gonna run for mostly cover so that the minimal amount of turrets can hit her. Run!
I rolled lower of the initiative.
Can't you just hide behind the steps of these little pillars things? Platforms.
And also the turrets are high enough up that they'd still be able to see her.
In the water with the
so the turrets aren't at ground level, they're kind of raised up more like
what about these
above head like 10 feet in the air?
Barricades you can hide behind in the river.
Yes, we're hiding in the river from the dragon snake. Excellent plan. Shyalu, your turn. Also, Zara, do you need to wake up early tomorrow?
Yep.
Okay. Noted. We will end on cliffhangers.
Did my master negotiation fail on him last round?
Yes.
Okay, then I can't try it again this round. Dang it.
Shyalu and Lexa, we're a great team. Got this.
Wave your hand, make my health bar go back up, please.
Only one of five hit you. I don't see what the problem here is.
Yeah, one of five and like a third of my health is gone. Okay, let's wait for the next one.
It also rolled almost max damage. It rolled an 8 and a 6 and a 7 on the damage roll.
You have full hit points. You did not die. You were not close to death.
I'm going to... If you fail a persuade roll on someone, you can't persuade them for 24 hours. So, persuasion is out.
Excellent.
I guess...
Worry about Aelond. I'm going to see if I can get a hold of the... and turn off the turrets from there.
Wait, how am I going to help Aelond?
Can you... Is he out of range? For your force stuff?
Wait, you're also up like in the air. Yeah, you're very... Well, you're not... You're very... You're like...
Does the force have range?
Yeah, that's it has
dumb.
A range of about 6 squares.
Oh, that's dumb.
The question is whether that includes vertical distance.
Yes, it does. It would include range for blaster rifles, so yes.
Let me do some quick math.
It's gonna be a no.
He's 6 squares this way and undetermined 0 squares this way. That means he's only 6 squares away.
If you fold it all into two-dimensional space, it all works out.
Exactly.
Okay. My plan on my turn is to turn off the turrets. So see if you could help me do that.
I mean, my plan was to try to take care of Jerec so he wouldn't interfere with turning off the turrets. I was going to try to use Force Stun on him.
Okay.
So I'm going to use Channel Vitality to give myself a temporary force point. And then we use Force Stun.
So whether it be 3 down the condition track?
Good job!
That would be 4.
Am I doing my math wrong?
It moves down one.
One extra. Oh, one extra.
One for every five over.
Five. Oh, yeah, it would be four. You're right. What was the rule for condition track for bosses?
They have 10 spots, and they can...
They have 10 spots. And it just goes one... It goes stepwise, right? Okay. So he's got a minus four.
Good job. That's helpful. Maybe this time I'll actually be able to grapple him.
Alrighty, it is Raydik's turn.
What crazy thing is that droid gonna do this time? More Edward Scissorhands?
Oh yeah, he's murder hoboing this guy with the nat 20.
Wait.
So yeah, his hands flash back and hit him in the back. This time, he's unprepared for the second strike.
Shyalu, I think it might be best if we try not to get in the way of this and do our normal thing, which is where we try not to kill everyone in the room. Maybe just let this happen. Not in the non-interference policy here.
Okay, Pachez, it is your
turn. I'd like to enact a non-interference policy. Just hold on 1 second while I throw this radiation grenade. Okay, now we're enacting it. Okay, good.
No. Hold. Hesitation. Then, now. Yep, there you go. Did my part.
Now it's your turn.
So how do charge attacks work, and do you need a feat to do this?
No, you can, so it's, you can move your whole movement speed for a charge attack, and you can also still have your move action. And you get a plus two, and you get a minus two to your reflex defense.
Yep.
That all sounds good to me. So I can move a little bit more than six.
So you can move 12.
Okay. So I want... So you said it was like right here, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I just run at it. Ignite my staff and just start slashing it at the paddle.
You're just slashing
where the explosive should have been.
Okay. Swing away.
One moment.
What was the damage on the... Did I roll the damage for the detonite, or did I not actually roll
it? Yeah, you rolled it. Although I think it should have been...
Four more than that?
I used double the rope in that.
Okay, console. I'll roll another 46 on top of that then. Okay. Alright, so you start slashing at it. And you've kind of turned the panel it was at, like, to scrap, pretty much, and you're trying to reach at the cables. You think you hit the last cable, and as you do...
I hate it when he says that.
Cliffhanger. Oh, like
the lights go out.
Except sort of for me, because I should at least be able to see the heat from people.
Yeah, I'll fix that for you later. And that is where we will end.
That was convenient timing. It's a good thing I figured out a charge attack would work.
I thought for sure that you were going to get Kalani awake. With the cure thing that was in the works. Apparently
what
not.
Cure thing?
I mean, you probably wake up and eventually get over to you. I'm sure Shia will give you the hand of wakefulness.
Oh yeah, that. Well, that concludes Legends of the Force for tonight, guys. Tune in next week to find the exciting cliff, or the exciting end sequel and whatnot to the end of this cliffhanger. Hope you guys had a good night. Thank you again, players, for joining us live. Hopefully next week we get a little bit more situated with the whole cameras and whatnot stuff and everything else, because technical difficulties are technical difficulties and I hate them. But anyways, good night, and I hope you guys who are tuning in on YouTube, I hope you guys have a good night and God bless.
Yeah, I was debating whether or not to have you get woken up for it, but then you and Aelond